Braggadocio about the number of driven wheels is refreshingly offbeat. Even better for Dodge, it didn't need to spend a lot of money on the effort. The Challenger shares its platform with the Charger sedan, which has long offered an all-wheel drive option. Keen to cash in on its recent double-digit sales growth in AWD models, Dodge simply pillaged its parts bin for the Charger's hardware and bolted it into the Challenger to hitch yet another model to the trend. Thus was born the Challenger GT. We'd like to imagine that the baptism included jeering and tomatoes thrown at the rear-drive-only Mustang and Camaro. The 305-horsepower Pentastar V6 isn't a total letdown, even though the GT must contend with another 200 pounds or so of front drive shafts, a transfer case, and larger standard wheels. The extra poundage associated with all-wheel drive strains the 6 off the line. Yet once the car is underway, the 8-speed automatic's wide ratio spread keeps the V6 huffing along. A sport mode strips the transmission of its inhibitions, loosening the requirements for initiating downshifts and holding on to lower gears longer. Drivers can swat the shift lever or use small steering wheel shift paddles to manually select ratios, but quick responses shouldn't be expected. The Challenger SRT model's stiffer suspension tuning doesn't mix with the GT's AWD bits, so the GT supports its extra weight by borrowing heavy-duty springs, dampers, and anti-roll bars from the AWD Charger Pursuit cop car. Dodge says it tuned these components for slightly softened responses to suit the Challenger's shorter wheelbase. The GT ably handles corners without dragging its door handles on the pavement, yet the ride is capital F firm. Over craggy main roads in the dead of winter, we experienced plenty of side-to-side head toss as wheels on the side closest to the road shoulder faithfully followed each wavy undulation, pothole, and crack. The ride quality is short of harsh, however, and at least wheel motions are decently managed, while the bodacious structure and tall section tires isolate brutal impacts from the cabin. On smoother roads, the Challenger continues to be a quiet cruiser that drives big because, well, it is big. On a snowy road course Dodge set up for our drive, the Challenger and its Michelin Primus EMX M4 all-season tires delivered safe understeer when driven cautiously. As with other all-wheel drive cars, judicious throttle use is necessary to overcome this tendency. Helpfully, the Challenger's transfer case sends a maximum of 38% of available torque to the front wheels, so that even if both ends of the car have similar levels of grip, the front-to-rear torque split is rear-biased. Pricing starts at $34,490, $6,400 above a base Challenger SXT and even $505 above the Hemi-powered RT. This is offset by a higher level of standard equipment than either of those models, including Chrysler's latest 8.4-inch Uconnect touchscreen, 19-inch wheels, leather seats, heated and ventilated in front, and a heated steering wheel.